Guys, it is 10 o'clock on Thursday morning. I'm going to go now and go to the doctor's. It is humid as all get up outside. So I have my hair cut yesterday and now it looks like I have no hair because it is flat to my head. It's crazy. But Ash is still here. She's here for about another hour and then she's going to work. So I'm just going to turn all these fans off because no one's going to be here. I'll have to put it on for Louie and Rox. Hey Ash, yeah. I'm going to turn everything off in here because I'm leaving. When you go, can you just put the AC on low, but on low, like number one for them? Just in case I'm there longer. Thank you. All right, guys, I'm going to go get my car cooled off. Summer we cool it off, winter we warm it up. But it's already like 80 odd, 85 I think it said. 87 with a heat factor in the 90s. Not bad for 10 a.m. Oh, coughed up, Luke. Could be money. Bless you. I think Louie has allergies. Anyway, we'll see you guys in a bit. I hope you're having a wonderful Thursday. Wish me luck. I know I'm going early. It's only a 17-minute drive. But I usually do x-rays first. Hopefully I won't do them today. I think it's a waste of time and a waste of money. Okay, so the car's been sitting in the sun for a little while and it's 104 in the sun. So that gives you an idea of what we're dealing with. Watch still says 87 with a high of 90. But like I said, with the humidity factor, we're like up there in like 80% today. Oh, it's hot, guys. Anyway. I'm so nervous. I don't like going to the doctors, let alone going alone, but off I go. 10:28, I made it. 12:28, that wouldn't be good. As you can see, parking is wonderful. That's the building all the way over there. That's the tip of the building. I have to go to the other side of the building. And I'm pretty much parked on the highway, which is just on the other side. Crazy. But anyway, it'll take me half an hour to get there. But I made it. Whoa, yay me, no mistakes. Thanks, Siri. Well, guys, I am well impressed. It is 11:45 and I'm out. I went in, took longer for her to check me in because the systems were slow. Then I had to, they have all these, whatchamacallits now, these, what you call them? Like iPads, and what they do is you check yourself, you go through all the information in there, and then I went, whoops, hello. Then I had to go for an x-ray, which is in a new spot now, which was good, because that was the thing I was nervous about the most, was going down in the elevator by myself, because I hate elevators. When I was six and we lived in Cyprus, I went up to our apartment. We lived on the beach, and well, not literally on the beach, but the apartments were at the beach. And I went up to the flat to get something and I got stuck in the lift and I got frightened. So I don't like them to this day. And then when I was pregnant with Ashley doing my Lamar's classes, we got stuck in the lift the first day. Six pregnant women and their spouses, and they had to have the fire department come because we were stuck between floors. And we had to kind of climb out of it, which was pretty funny at 8 months pregnant. And they had all doctors and nurses there waiting for us to come out. It was pretty funny. Not at the time. But I must say, I'm the only one that didn't panic. Well, these pregnant women were panicking and the husbands weren't much help. He just went right into action, trying to like call people, do things, you know what I mean? Anyway, so I'm gonna head home now and might get something to eat on the way home. I don't have to go back until November 9th, so that's exciting. Got 4 months, but he's one of these, call me if you need me, are we just going to keep doing what we're doing? I'm like, yep, for now we're just going to keep doing what we're doing. So that's the plan. I hope no one's watching me because I can't see in anyone's cars because of the light. Anyway, I just walked a mini marathon, so I'm going to go now get some food and go home and see how many phone calls I have to make. So I'll talk to you guys in a bit. Hey, everyone, home in the office. It is, look at me, I'm like dripping. It's absolutely wicked out there. I put the AC on in here about half an hour ago. 10 minutes ago, before I took the dogs out. I just came in from taking the dogs and I'm glistening. It's so hot. It's so hot. Anyway, I'm going to download my clips. I have a couple of messages I see blinking away on the machine over there. I'm going to see who they are. And I'll talk to you guys in a little bit. I'm not sitting down here till 5 o'clock with the computers on and the heat that they generate. No way. I'll be going upstairs shortly. Look, here it comes. Here it comes. Here it comes. Talk to you in a bit. Getting really windy and nasty. Bird looked like he was heading for the window. Guys, as you can see, it's still very muggy. That little tiny teeny storm did absolutely diddly squat. It was windy for about 10 minutes, the heavens opened up, it poured, and it stopped, and the thick air is back. But this is a very short vlog today, it's 27 minutes past 8. We had fish and chips, chicken and chips, fish and chips. Pete brought them back from, I was going to say Maine. Pete brought them back from, on his way home. And we were going to go over to Pete's mum's after to go just visit with her, have a cup of tea, but she's actually out having dinner with friends, so that's nice. See her out and about, so we'll see her over the weekend at some point. We have Paige's play this weekend. We're gonna go Saturday night because I think it'll be easier for us to go on Saturday night. Then Friday night with Pete trying to get home with the traffic and everything. Sometimes he can be held up and not get home till 6:30, and the play starts at 7, so it would be too much of a rush. Anyway, that's where we're at. When I went to, I had the x-rays done at the doctor's office. And I go in, it's all new, it's a different area, it's right around the corner. And the girl goes to me, can you, have a bra on? I'm like, yeah. And she goes, okay, can you take it off? And I looked at her, she goes, you don't have to. She goes, can you pull it all the way up so that the little clasps in the back, sorry guys, I know it's probably too much info for you. And I'm like, I'd rather pull it up because it's 100 degrees outside. Have you tried putting a bra on in 100 degree weather when you're just like, ugh. No, it's not the easy thing to put on a good day, especially when you got a bad back, because I can't twist and turn, and so to have the added humidity on top, I wasn't about to take it off and then spend an hour trying to get the blooming thing back on again. That was my excuse anyway. So of course she comes out and she goes, well, the clips are still too low, and I'm like, well, I'm sorry, I can't reach. I put it up as far as I could, so she yanked it up. I'm like, well, hello. Buy me dinner first. It was funny. Anyway, at one point, she just kept pulling me and pushing me around as to where she wanted me. And then she goes, you're about to slap me, aren't you? I'm like, no, not at all. She goes, I'm sorry, I realized. She goes, I'm not communicating. I'm just kind of pushing and pulling you in places. I'm like, And then she saw my x-rays and she went, oh, I hope you feel better. I was like, thank you. Aren't they pretty? I was going to take a picture of it up on the wall again, up on the TV screen while I was waiting for the doctor to come in. Because there's all different angles now, and just the way that the screws are in, I just got pain looking at them. They're all like poking down into my spine. But anyway, I could see the compressions above it, so at least I know what the pain's from. Well, I knew it anyway, didn't I? But why are we on that subject? I don't know. I'm going to go now and talk to you guys tomorrow. I hope everybody had a brilliant, brilliant Thursday. Whatever it is you guys did today, I hope it was a good one, and we will see you tomorrow. Good night.